for many kids, and some adults, too, building a snow fort is as much a staple of a good winter weekend as snowmen, snowball fights, snow angels, and a comforting cup of hot cocoa. It's an innocent, wholesome activity, and more than a few parents probably encourage it. That was certainly the case with Nova Scotia resident Steve Bears, who was playing with his son, Ben, and the boy's friend, Adam Inch, in the massive snow fort that they had built. Everybody was having a great time, until something terrifying happened. The fort unexpectedly collapsed on top of them, and the snow was so heavy that they couldn't escape. That's when Steve felt something tugging on him. Come wintertime, there are few outdoor activities quite as wholesome and fun as making a snow fort. It ranks right up there with snowball fights and downhill sledding, and there's an undeniable excitement to crawling into your own handcrafted hovel after working so hard to build it. That's why for Nova Scotia resident Steve Bear, his son, Ben, and Ben's friend, Adam Inch, digging into some fresh snow and making a little fort seemed like the perfect way to spend a wintry afternoon. Of course, they didn't realize their idea of fun would nearly get them killed. While they were digging, the roof of their fort collapsed, pinning all three of them beneath the freezing snow. Enveloped in total darkness, none of the three could move a limb. They were trapped and they would surely suffocate if they didn't get help fast. Luckily for Steve, Ben, and Adam, there was a fourth member of the Bear family outside that day, the family dog, a 5-year-old golden retriever Labrador mix named Zeus. But what could he do? I knew it was very serious when my arms were pinned underneath me, Steve told Global News. My heel was into my back, he added. Compounding his trauma, he could hear both of the boys screaming. I didn't know what happened, Ben recalled. I thought someone just jumped on me. And then I realized the weight just kept gaining and gaining, and that's when I realized I couldn't really move. Adam's comments only underscore just how scary the situation was. It was pitch black, he said. We heard everybody screaming and stuff. We were right beside each other, at the top of your lungs and couldn't hear them very well. Hopeless as the situation seemed, the fourth member of the fort construction crew had all of his paws available to help. As soon as the fort collapsed, Zeus immediately started digging at the snowy heap. Zeus dug in and started to pull the back of my jacket, Steve said, and I knew at that point, if I could get an arm or a leg free and get my leg untwisted, I had a chance of getting out and helping the kids. In the end, Steve couldn't praise his heroic pooch enough. Zeus was the inspiration, he said. I can't say it enough. Zeus is definitely a hero, especially considering that those three would have likely suffered far worse fates if it wasn't for his help. Hopefully, this story will also shed a light on the importance of safety when playing in the snow. Share this surprising story with your friends below.